Hi folks, welcome to day three of my eating plan. What I done last week and I lost...
I have to say,
what?
It's not all about you. My eating plan.
Yeah, but this is my eating plan, baby. You're doing something different than me.
Well, people are interested in the keto.
I'm vegetarian. Yeah, I know that, but that's
aren't
a...
you?
That
I would be I've a, seen the comments.
That would be a different set of videos, Sharon.
No, you
can
want
I carry
me
on,
here.
Baby?
You want me in it, so it's about me and
I've all. Got to have you in it, Sharon.
Otherwise, you're, I'll go and sit
you're,
out there.
You're my right-hand man.
I'm a woman.
Right, I must stand corrected on my last video I'd done because I said twice in that video, especially right at the very beginning, that it's a low fat. It's not low fat. I'm vegetarian, dairy free, and very low carb diet. Yeah? So anyway, this is lunchtime the next day, day three on my 7-day eating plan, just to show you what I've been eating over the past 7 days that's enabled me to take control of my blood sugar. I'm type 2 diabetic, as you know, and also to lose 10 pounds in body weight within the first week. So this is what we're going to have now, Cheryl. What are we going to have? What are you going to have?
I'm having the keto muffin with spicy cheese on
top. Remember the keto bread we made in yesterday's recipe? Well, I'm going to do it now just for our afternoon snack. And all we're doing is scaling up the recipe, basically. Oh, I forgot to get the bleaching almond flour, Sharon.
You're not going to get far out of that, are you?
Again, as you know, it's got to be simple.
Expensive stuff.
Oh, just talking to someone. Almond flour is very, very dear, unfortunately. But I've just bought 1 kilogram off of Amazon, and that's cost me £13 for 1 kilogram. Normally, you buy it in 250 kilogram portion sizes, which is about that much there, as you can probably see there in that mason jar. And that, how much is that? About £3, isn't it? £2.50, £3.
But we've also discovered you can ground almonds in your processor.
To buy almonds in their whole form, in the husk, in the shell, not in the shell, in the nut form, you can put them in a what's it called? A blender, and actually grind them up and make the same thing, and they are a bit cheaper if you want to do it that way. But you have to stand there, obviously pour it in, whiz it up, and takes a bit longer.
Pour it in and press a button.
Right, so okay, so when we're doing our muffins, keto muffins for two people, I call them keto muffins, no carb bread, I'm gonna call it, Sharon, is that all right? Because I'm not on the keto at the moment, as you know. I'm not eating meat, as you know. So we call it low carb or no carb bread. So all we do, there's our container, which we had yesterday. I've got the almond flour again. I'll let you do the mixing, Shell,
no,
don't worry. And instead of putting 3 scoops in, because there's two of us, I'm gonna put 6 scoops in. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 dessert spoons. Oh, shut that door. Put that over there, baby. Baking powder, instead of 1/2 teaspoon, I'm going to use the same big spoon, and I'm just roughly going to measure out what I think is a teaspoon, probably about that, and whack that in. I'll tell you what, baby, you can go and put that back if you like. It's entirely up to you. We're going to drop not one egg in there this time, we're going to drop two eggs in there. So 2 full eggs. 1. This is literally double the recipe which we done yesterday. 2 full eggs. And normally what we do, as I said to you, would be a knob of butter, which I can't have because I'm dairy free, as I told him yesterday, baby. So all we do there is we just put a splurge. Look, watch my splurge. Of olive oil. Now you can stir that, baby. So we're gonna have the muffins. As you know, we slice them up as we did yesterday. We're going to put an egg on it. Avocado, we went out and bought something today, baby, didn't we?
Mm-hmm.
And we're also, Sharon's going to have cheese on her one. And we're also going to have a bowl of mixed salad. What I will also do is just, again, in the frying pan, wilt down some spinach first, and I'll just sling that on the top of it as well. So Sharon's mixing out now. So there's double our mixture, what we had yesterday. Now, as you can probably see there, it's up to, oh, back there. Go and put that in, baby. And also a mistake I made yesterday, I said, at the beginning, I said you put that on for 180 seconds. Well, that's for 2 portions. She's now putting that on for 180 seconds. If you're doing it for a single portion, which is basically half that, 90 seconds. So that's going on for, that's 6 presses of the microwave, baby. Avocado, again, very great. It's got the great oils in it. Look at that, look. I used to hate these, never used to get on with them. Twist, out comes the stone, look at that. Right, can we just show that, Sharon? She's bringing the bread over now. Look how that's risen in that short time, look. 180 seconds, look at that, fall right to the top, look. And all we're gonna do...
Half it.
Hey? Half it, what do you mean half it?
We've got the same amount each.
Oh yeah.
I don't wanna be cheated.
Oh, you don't wanna be cheated, I don't cheat you, Sharon. Let's tip that out, look, let's put it on there, look. Look at that, look. That's your keto bread. Absolutely fantastic. Oh, I know it's hot, baby. Just let that sit for a minute. Now, the avocados, again, is such a wonderful piece of... is it a fruit shell?
I don't know.
We just spoon it out like that and just tip it out. It makes it so much easier, look. And this is so good for you. The oils in this are absolutely fantastic for your body, believe it or not. So just put a knife through it, baby. You ain't even got to pick it up, just cut it on the board, that's it. Look at that, look. Everything's done on the cutting board, Shell, isn't it? So apart from our lettuce leaves, that's it. Oh, we didn't get an onion out, Shell. Do you want to get an onion out, baby? Any time today? Can you move over? Oh, come on, come around, come around. That's it, sorry, baby. This town ain't big enough for the both of us, baby. Now, she has this, as I say, it's a... like a Mexicana cheese, Sharon has. This one's got a red rind around it, so that just pulls off of there, look. Like that. This isn't for me, by the way, because I can't eat this because I'm dairy-free at the moment. So the whole reason I'm eating this is because it's taken me probably 10 to 15 years to get to the condition that I'm at now with insulin resistance. See, and when you've got insulin resistance, that's sort of pre-diabetes. That's a sign that you're eating too much carbohydrate and refined sugars in your diet. But your body, the thing is, there's no symptoms, apart from you may start to gain weight, feel tired, lethargic, things like that. But no one checks your insulin when you go to the doctors because there's no symptoms. And basically, you'll check for sugar, in other words, for diabetes, if you've got too much sugar in your blood. But pre-diabetes, which is insulin resistance, which they reckon 70% of the population have got and don't actually know about it, is your body's ability to control the sugar in your blood because you're putting so much sugar in there that your pancreas pumps out more and more insulin into your system to keep your blood sugars normal. So when you have a blood sugar test, that looks normal, but you're eating a high refined carbohydrate processed diet, your insulin, your pancreas, is pushing out so much more insulin. So insulin's never measured, which it should be, because that's the precursor to diabetes type 2, which is too much insulin, and everybody suffers from that. And also, having too much insulin in your system, which you obviously don't know, is just as bad, if not worse, than having too much sugar in your system. Just to let you know, check your insulin levels, ask your doctor, and they'll say, I don't know what you mean, we don't do that test. Oh, doorbell, hold on. Doorbell's just gone. I think it's a delivery. What is it, baby?
I don't know, I'm not ordering
nothing. Hey? Oh, I know what that is, there.
That's addressed to me, so...
Oh, is it?
What I think you think it is.
Oh, that's what I've been waiting for. Oh yeah, this is it. Hey, I just ordered this, look. This come. This is what I've ordered. I've ordered it on Amazon.
That's my brother's.
Oh, is it your brother's?
Look.
Oh yeah, get rid of it. Get rid of it, Cheryl. That's what I've just ordered. It's just come. It's a kilogram of almond flour. I've just got that off of Amazon, and that's 1 kilogram. So that's cost me £13.
Ridiculous.
It is ridiculous, but it's a lot better than buying them small little bags for £2.50 sort of thing, yeah? So anyway, that was that. Deliveries. So you cut your cheese up now. You're happy with that. I'm just going to slide a knife through. Put that there for a minute, baby. Through our buns. Well, in fact, you can do that, Shell. Shell, listen. I've got to get the camera.
I haven't recovered from yesterday.
Yeah, well... All right, you get the camera then. Last, when I told her to do this yesterday, you never saw it. She cut it all wonky. I said, all you had to do was cut a straight line. Oh, that light's gone out, look. Right, as I say, it's just cooled off now, as you can see there. And all I'm going to do is, I'm just going to slide the knife through it and just make 4 buns in it.
No, you usually get 3, don't we?
Yeah, oh, we'll have an extra one then. I like an extra one.
No, but it's for 2 people.
Yeah, I know it's for 2 people, baby. Trust me, I'm a doctor. 2. That's what I said, 2 buns. 3, 4. I like an extra. There's always an extra one left over, which I like. Yeah?
What's for him,
so, 2 for Sharon, 2 for me, 1 extra one for the butcher's dog. Same as yesterday, we're just going to plonk that on our grill, just like that. And then that just goes into our grill, and we're gonna whack the grill on and let that just sort itself out. Right, just like yesterday, we've got our pan on. I'm gonna just put a splash of olive oil in there just to stop things from sticking. And what I will do is I'll just whack our spinach in first. I'm gonna put all that in, look. I'll whack all that in, because that really does go down to nothing. You can really throw this in there. If I had a lid now, I'd put a lid on there so it'd steam, and that'll go down a lot quicker.
You've not said that before, have you?
Hey?
Not said that before.
I do repeat myself, Sharon, don't I?
You do.
Right, and I'll just push that over to the end of the frying pan, just to give my eggs a bit of room, because they're still cooking there. And I'm just going to crack mine and Sharon's eggs.
I want egg.
Oh, please have egg.
Not all
right,
cheese.
All right, if you don't want egg, I'll have yours.
I just thought you was having two eggs up.
Well, I will have two eggs then, it's not a problem. See, eggs are absolutely fine. All what you've read before about eggs being full of cholesterol and all that and bad for you, it's actually not true. So let's let that cook away. So let's just turn these over. Yeah, we just whack them over. Like that. Ooh, I've done that. What am I doing? That's it. Right, so while they're cooking up there, I'm just going to pull this out again for a second. Put it up here for a minute. Because we're just going to put Sharon's cheese on. A couple of these. Yeah, look, like that, look. Just like that. I'm having them free, by the way. And I'm going to bring them ones to the back and put them ones at the front there, only because our grill tends to cook more at the front. So then we put that back under. And I'm just going to just move things about a bit. There we go. Right, spinach is cooked now, so I'm gonna leave that like that. Just break them eggs in two. There we go. Like that. Right, so I'm just gonna take my buns out. I'm gonna leave Sharon's under there just to cook for a bit longer. Right, there's my three buns there. Just like yesterday, I just wanna put a little bit of this mayonnaise on there. Again, none of that low fat stuff, there's more sugar in that. I'm just going to flip my eggs over. That's the way I like them. Is that called over easy, Shay? I'm not sure.
It's just called a fried egg to me.
Just a fried egg, baby, I know. Spinach is cooked now, and they're over to me bun. Now, look at this, look. Straight on top of two of me buns. There's one. There's two. I'm going to leave my spinach there. Right, let's have a look at Sharon's now. Oh, look at them little babies. Oh, look at them, Shell. Again, I can't eat these. I'd love to eat them now, but I'm on the dairy-free. Where do you want your spinach? On the side or?
Just a small amount. That's it.
That do you?
That'll do me. It's more than enough.
Right, well, me, I'll whack it on, Shell, as you probably know.
Well, you do.
So I'm going to whack that on there like that. Right, my avocado. I'm just going to whack on there. We have a half each, don't we, Shell?
Mm.
Like that. Right, she's funny where she wants her, so she's going to have hers down that side. And there you go. We've just dished up a portion of salad each. I like a bit more than Sharon. She likes a smaller portion. Let's just have a look at this. And as you can see, that is my meal there for my lunch there. I've got my keto bread there. I've got my two eggs on there. I've got my avocados. I've got my spinach.
That's keto bread.
It is keto. All right, then.
You said you weren't going to call it that anymore.
Hey?
You said you weren't going to call it that anymore.
What, keto bread?
Yeah.
What did I say I was going to call it?
Muffin.
Yeah, no, something
almond.
Else.
Almond.
No.
I can't remember.
No carb bread, that was it, wasn't it?
Oh, there you go.
There's my no carb bread that Sharon's quickly pointed out. And there's my big bowl of salad, which I'm going to dress in a second. Again, if you're doing the keto, you can have it like this with that cheese on the top. Look at that, Sharon. That absolutely looks lovely. Them muffins there with that cheese on like that. Spicy cheese. You've got to try it out, I tell you. If you ever want a snack, that will sort you out, I'm telling you. Right, okay, baby. Again, just like yesterday. Pink Himalayan salt. Don't be frightened of the salt. You eat the right salt, it's very, very good for you. Ground white pepper. Again, put it on the taste. And this Maggi seasoning, if you like savoury foods, then this is the way to go. Whack a bit of that on. Lovely. Because I can, I'm just going to put a little drop of mayonnaise on there like that. You don't have to do that, obviously. Give you this chair squeaking, shall? Yeah. And here we go. Look at this, look. That's my keto bread with my egg and a bit of that. Oh, look at this. Oh. It's so good. So good. I'll dress my salad as well, exactly the same way as I did yesterday. And we're going to sit down and enjoy this now. Watch out for later on, the evening meal. Don't forget you can chop and change these, and it's literally minutes to prepare. But we're eating whole foods. That's the main thing what I'm trying to get to. Very little processed foods, no carbs, no dairy, and no meat for me. Anyway, see you a bit later on. Right, Wednesday evening now. It seems like only 2 minutes ago before we was at the lunchtime meal, Sharon.
There you go.
Hey? So, right, what I'm going to have is a chilli, basically. And we've got some stuff to put in here. And with it, I've got this Four Seasons cauliflower rice. It's not really rice, it's cauliflower. So let's just run you through. I've actually prepped the vegetables. It's, again, no measuring. You put in what you want. This is what I'm putting in. So as you know, this is the meatless mince, which we had yesterday, 400 grams. So I'm going to have half of that anyway, but I'm going to cook all this together in one pot and I'll have the next half for tomorrow. So that's the mince, or the meatless mince. All I've done here, I've diced up one large onion. I've got two little chilies there, green and a red chili. I've got three cloves of garlic, and I had some, again, some asparagus left in the fridge, about five or six sticks of it, and I've just chopped it all up there. I've got a tin of chopped tomatoes, and I'm putting in chickpeas. Sharon's never done this before. We had them in the cupboard. They're very good. They're virtually no carbs in them whatsoever. And again, they've got plenty of protein in. I've actually drained these out, by the way. I don't put the juice in because you find sometimes, just like baked beans, the juices can contain sugar. So that's it. I've drained them out and put them back in the can just for ease of showing you. We've got some chili flakes there. We've got some mild chili powder and some ground cumin and also some Italian seasoning. We just throw bits in to taste. There's no measuring. Right, so as before, we're just going to put a little bit of olive oil in just to line the bottom of the pan. And look at that, look, it does look like mince, doesn't it? Doesn't it, baby?
Oh, yeah.
So, always tip it up. They normally put... Eh?
That's the colour mince I've chucked away.
They normally put this paper on the bottom, so make sure you take that off. So, again, I'm just going to put that in there.
Oh, yummy.
So, we call it browning the mince, although it's not on meat. It's not on meat, really, is it, Cher? So I'll just chop this up into little pieces and just brown it. Right, so as you can see, that's been browning off nicely now. Now what I'm gonna do with that is just transfer it into a saucepan because we're gonna cook the other stuff down now and then add all the ingredients as we go. So I'm gonna put that in there like that. I'm going to add our tin tomatoes. I'm going to add our chickpeas, the whole tin. Don't have to measure nothing here. Just give it a quick stir around, so just get all that mixed up. I'm just going to sling some of these herbs in. Some chilli flakes as well. Mild chilli powder. That's not necessary, again, but it's just something I want to try. And we've also got ground cumin as well. Again, all to taste. Just stir that through. Again, it might look a bit dry at the moment, but we could always put a bit of liquid in that as well. Sharon reckons we can do with a little drop of her tomato puree in there as well. Again, it's all low sugar stuff, this, so don't worry about that. So just stir that round. A little drop more of olive oil. And in we go with everything else. There we go. Again, with this mince, it's all about adding the flavour to it. If you rely on just the mince on its own, you probably are going to find it a little bit bland. So we add the flavour to it, and we're doing so with whole vegetables. So we're just going to let that sizzle about a bit, cook off a little bit, before we add it to the main saucepan over there. Right, there you go. They've all cooked down nicely now. So I'm just going to incorporate them into our mince. Oh, it smells absolutely lovely. All the garlic and chilies I can smell. So just give that a mix through. Cheers. Right, so let's just whack a drop in there like that. Again, suck it and see. I don't really know how much. I'm just stirring it away. Now, the best way to do this is to put it in a dish and actually put it in the oven. Trouble with doing it on the hob like this is that you've got the heat at the bottom and that can actually burn the bottom, so you've got to keep turning it around. If you lay it in a dish, put it in the oven, that's probably... Shall we do it that way?
Well, I myself would have made it this morning, so...
Yeah, well, you normally make it in front of time, don't you? But we'll take it off of there, forget about that. We'll put it in a bowl and we'll put it in the oven. So once you've just warmed it all through, just put it in a casserole pot. So yeah, Sharon just said you can do it in a slow cooker as well and leave it on in a slow cooker. There you go. Right, so in she goes. 20 minutes and I'm ready. Here we go. Look at that. Oh, lovely old job. Very, very hot. Now, again, this is going to do it for 2 days. I'm going to have another go in here. As I say, eating like this, you can actually eat lots.
You do.
And I do like to eat lots. There we go. So that will go back in a bowl for tomorrow. I'll have that tomorrow, maybe for lunch or even maybe in the evening. I don't know yet. So again, I'm just going to whack a bit of pepper on it, whack a bit of salt on it, because the cauliflower can be a little bit bland, so that's that. My old favourite Maggie, put that on the cauliflower, as I say, because the cauliflower is a little bit bland. Sorry, I'm going to put it over everything. I don't care, Shell. Right, so here we go, first taste. Let's have a little go. Oh, yeah. Thing with the chickpeas in, you can put beans in there. If you're going to put beans in it, put the beans in a colander and get all the sauce off by putting it under a cold tap. You don't want that sugary syrup. I know it's nice, but you can't have it. Well, that's my tea tonight. Sharon's on the keto diet, as you know.
I'm just looking at the steam on yours compared to my dinner.
Yeah, yours has been out for a little bit longer than mine, hasn't it? So Sharon's got chops there, 4 small pork chops. She's got mixed veg. And what you can't see in there, she's waiting for them to brown off. She's got diced up, what is it, swede?
Turnip.
And that's what we're having for tonight's dinner. So that's it, that's another meal over and done with. Or another 2 meals, baby. Hope they've enjoyed this series. I've had a lot of feedback off of this shout and people are loving it.
I'd just like to have a hot dinner.
See you in the next video. Oh, we've got another vegetarian just come in. Look at this.
I don't want to be a guest.
Come on.
I don't want to be a guest.
He's just turned up. Look, he's a vegetarian, Chris. He's been
I'm looking at this.
Yeah.
And I'm wanting to try this. There's always a text coming in there.
Yeah. Go on then. Carry on.
And this is what?
This is that meat-free mince.
Okay.
You're a vegetarian. You've been a vegetarian for years.
It smells a bit curry-ish.
Chili.
She's put a few spices in.
You've done it. Chili.
Yeah.
It's chili.
Go on. Is that all right? Is that edible?
I would happily have that as a meal. That's lovely.
Yeah. Oh, lovely. Thank you very much indeed.
Really nice. Oh. Oh,
dead chops.
Dead animals, sis.
Come on, let's go and talk about plants. Come on, off we go. See you later, folks.